अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? टुडे वी हैव टू रिवाइज द टॉपिक ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट. स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन टू बॉडीज एट डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर्स आर इन थर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट विद ईच अदर, थर्मल एनर्जी फ्लो फ्रॉम अ हॉट बॉडी टू अ कोल्ड बॉडी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हीट इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट. ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट इज अ नेचुरल प्रोसेस. इट कंटिन्यूज ऑल द टाइम एज लॉन्ग एज द बॉडीज इन थर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट आर एट डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर्स. There are three ways by which heat transfer take place. These are conduction, convection, and radiations. Today we will revise conduction in detail. It is a common observation that if you try to stir a hot soup in a saucepan with a metal spoon, thermal energy flows quickly from the soup through the spoon to your fingers. The movement of heat through the solid such as metal is called conduction. The metal spoon conducts the heat from the soup to your fingers. Metals are best conductor of heat because heat can easily pass through them. Cooking pots are made up of metals so that heat from the cooker can get easily through the food. Metals like aluminium, copper, zinc, iron, they are very good conductor of heat. Copper is the best conductor of heat. It conducts heat 10 times better than iron. Non-metals such as glass and plastics, they are poor conductor of heat because heat cannot easily pass through them, but they do not allow the heat to pass through them. They are also known as insulators. Air is a very good insulator. Materials such as fur, feathers, wool, plastic foam, glass, or mineral wools are good insulators because they contain pockets of trapped air, and air is a good insulator. You know that styrofoam is also a good insulator, and styrofoam boxes are used to keep the food hot or ice cream cold for a long time. Styrofoam does not allow the heat to leave or enter the box easily. Next, we have to study conduction and the kinetic theory. Student, this is a long metal bar. The long metal bar, the particles, that is atom or molecules, they are moving, vibrating at their fixed position in the framework. When we apply heat to them, we are supplying heat at one end of the metal bar. The particles at this end of the metal bar gain thermal energy and vibrate faster. This causes the particles next to them to vibrate faster as well. Bit by bit, the increased vibrations of the particle is passed along the bar until the whole bar is heated. In this way, heat has been conducted along the metal bar. Now, you can see that it is the heat energy that transfer from one end of the metal bar to the other, that is from hot end of the metal bar towards the cold end, and not the atoms. Heated atoms do not move, they remain on their fixed position. Next, we have to do the test yourself. Question number one, which materials make the best conductors of heat? The answer will start from this line. Metals are the best conductor of heat. Up to this line, food quickly. Question number two, what is an insulator? Name three insulators. The answer will start from this line, non-metals, solid, and end at this line. Question number three, explain how heat is conducted along a metal bar. Answer will start from this line, if one end of a metal bar is heated, up to this line, including this diagram also. Question number four, suggest why A, the base of a saucepan is made of metal. Whether the base of a saucepan is made of metal, because metals are good conductor of heat, they allow the heat to pass them easily, and in this way, heat from the cooker can easily get to the food. बी द हैंडल ऑफ अ सॉसपैन इज मेड ऑफ प्लास्टिक इट इज बिकॉज प्लास्टिक इज अ गुड इंसुलेटर इट डज नॉट अलाउ द हीट टू पास थ्रू इट एंड इट प्रिवेंट द हॉट हैंड फ्रॉम बर्निंग सी पोलर बियर्स हैव अ थिक कोट ऑफ फर द आंसर इज दैट द थिक कोट ऑफ फर कंटेन्स पॉकेट्स ऑफ ट्रैप्ड एयर एंड फर हेल्प्स द बियर टू रिटेन इट्स बॉडी टेम्परेचर डी बर्ड्स फ्लफ आउट देयर फीदर्स इन विंटर फ्लफी फीदर्स आर वेरी गुड इंसुलेटिंग मटीरियल्स बाय फ्लफिंग इट्स फीदर अ बर्ड ट्रैप्स मैनी टाइनी पॉकेट्स ऑफ एयर टू होल्ड इन बॉडी हीट एंड कीप आउट द कोल्ड थैंक यू